The initial price is less than 1,700 yuan. You can get a multicolor enclosed 3D printer that supports carbon fiber and glass fiber reinforced materials. This is the result of the current fierce competition in the 3D printer market. You can print almost any model you want, right on your desk at home, like movable toys, functional parts, or prototypes for creative products. You can even print industrial-grade items made from high-strength materials that are heat-resistant, impact-resistant. The ELEGOO CC, which I've been beta testing for almost a year, hasn't even been officially released yet. But the CC2 generation is already on the market. The main body looks quite similar. The second generation is like the first one loaded, with a lot of upgrades, making it much more powerful. So let's take a look at the feature of ELEGOO's first FDM multicolor 3D printer, ELEGOO CC2. During unboxing, it's basically a complete machine right out of the box. You mainly just need to install its multicolor components, and then you can start printing. But I have to complain a bit here. A few screws during installation are really awkward to access. The provided standard L-shaped wrench isn't very easy to apply force with, but this is only a minor hassle. During the initial unboxing, it doesn't affect anything afterwards. After assembly, let's look at the overall structure and materials. It uses a CoreXY structure overall, an all-aluminum alloy frame and metal side panels. The front has a glass door. The maximum build value of the print platform is 256 cubic millimeters. This is the side I just finished print on. This side has adhesive applied and is a textured surface. The other side is specifically for printing PLA. It's a relatively smooth surface, better suited for printing models that require a specific bottom finish, making it less prone to warping. This side is for printing larger models, making them less likely to detach. The main components of the high-speed cooling system inside the chassis include model cooling fans, high-power auxiliary cooling fans, and built-in external circulation fans of the box. This allows for better control of the chassis temperature. It also features a full machine fan self-test, including the internal fans, to ensure the equipment is operating normally. The exhaust vent on the back also has a hidden feature. Opening this reveals a filter module below, with some baffles on it. Here's the key point. There's a chassis temperature maintenance option on the interface. Click it, and the baffles will automatically close. This achieves better sealing inside the chamber, allowing the temperature to be maintained more effectively, supporting the printing of materials that require a stable ambient temperature, like ABS. This machine comes directly configured with a hardened steel direct drive extruder, a 350 degrees Celsius hotend, and a brass plus hardened steel nozzle. The platform supports up to 110 degrees Celsius, so you can easily print ABS, ASA, TPU, and even reinforced materials like carbon fiber and glass fiber. It's very powerful. If you usually print with filament like PLA, you'd typically print with the door open and don't need to add the insulation hood on top. So let's check its footprint. The front width is about 49 cm. The depth is 55 cm. Now let's look at the height. Because it has a filament changer on top, we need to measure including this part with the Teflon pipeline. It's about 76 cm tall. But if you need to print filaments requiring a heated chamber, then you need to put on this insulation hood. After adding this hood, its actual height is still about 76 cm. With the hood on, its height is actually similar to a regular printer with a multicolor system box added on top. Personally, I think it looks better without the hood, but currently, this is an insulation solution. I believe more users might modify the top part later. You just type on the screen, and it completes automatic bed leveling. Let's print a first layer to check. It's very level, no issues. Now for a routine unboxing test, print a Benchy. The surface is very smooth, and the overhangs are fine. While printing the Benchy, I tested its noise level with the door open. The noise is loudest during the high-speed movement. Testing from 1.5 meters away, the measured noise is about 63 dB. After closing the door and putting on the insulation hood, the noise drops to about 52 dB. This test result is considered excellent among similar 3D printers. However, even for FDM 3D printers, it's not recommended to place them where people frequently stay. It's better put them in a separate room. If used in the next room or on a balcony, it's completely fine. Let's try printing a multicolor bolt. The color change is very smooth. The entire curved surface is seamless, without noticeable layer lines. The overhangs for the windows and door are also fine. You can see there's an RFID recognition error directly above the four filament spools on the side. In ELEGOO's newer filament spools, RFID is built in. Each time, you just need to tap the spool here, and it will automatically recognize it. Because I'm currently using old vision spools, I can't demonstrate or experience the RFID function. But I think about the process, it's probably just tapping the spool here. It can identify your filament type and color. Then you select its spool slot here, and then load it normally. This adds one extra step each time. Compared to have an RFID reader for each slot, it's slightly more troublesome. But considering the price, it seems tolerable. After all, adding three more RFID readers, one for each slot, would be an additional cost. 3D printer is your creative assistant. The more capable it is, the more space you've got to let your creativity flow. If you are a model enthusiast, you'll probably spend more time not searching for models for sale, but rather adding .stl after a certain seam to find the file and print it yourself. Gradually, you might try modeling yourself to print a unique creation that belongs only to you. If you are a product designer, you can use industrial-grade filaments to create high-strength prototypes or even achieve small-batch production. After completing the basic test, I tried printing two magnetic-style Pokemon models. First is a Mewtwo in marble filament. The texture is amazing. This is also my first time using this marble color filament, and the print really has that marble-like texture. The model printed perfectly as one piece without issues. The curve of the large tail is also very smooth. Then I added a silk filament and printed a multicolor magnet-style Charizard. You can see there's an auto-switch filament option in the software. This is a very practical feature. In the past, when the spool was nearly empty, it often wasn't enough to continue printing a model, so you had to save it. Then it accumulates more and more. But with the auto switch feature, I can hang an additional spool of the same filament type. It prioritizes using the spool with less filament. When that one runs out, the next one automatically continues. Another scenario, if I only print with one color filament per day, like loading four spools of white, then I can achieve continuous large model printing unattended. At this price range, I think there's almost no room for price competition for other 3D printers. If you are a model enthusiast or work in design-related fields, this machine is still very worthwhile as an entry-level device for beginners. After all, buying a refined large decorative piece or a complex model can cost over 1,000 yuan. If you don't know how to model, ELEGOO has just launched its own model website, Next Print. It's still in beta, but it already has a lot of content. See if there's anything you like to download and print with one click. Moreover, filament is getting cheaper now, about 40 RMB per kilogram. For example, this Charizard model I printed with so many supports only consumed a little, or 130 grams of filament, costing just a few. As for actual power consumption, I measured it with a smart plug. During continuous multicolor printing, it consumes about 0.12 kWh per hour on average. 24 hours of continuous multicolor printing consumes less than 3 kWh of electricity, also costs just a few. So electricity cost isn't a problem either, just print freely. So if you are interested in design or creating original products, getting this machine is definitely worth it.
I'll keep sharing more awesome tech and creative stuff too. Catch you in the next video.